Coming up on this week's news, industry watchdog MCS reveals the top mistakes that electricians make when installing renewables. A popular Sangamo timer range is recalled over the risk of shock, burns and suffocation. And a petition demanding an inquest into the death of electrician Matthew Campbell has hit 2,000 signatures. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly. Whether you're listening in the van, on site or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The industry watchdog has revealed the top mistakes that electricians make when installing renewables. The microgeneration certification scheme says there are 8 standout reasons that projects fail its evaluations. It says it's not out to bash contractors with the list, so please don't get yourselves into a funk over this. Instead, the MCS says it's disclosing the non-conformities for the first time because it wants to raise awareness in the trade and eliminate the issues for good. The list is based on the 86 assessments it carried out in February. 49 of these were solar installs and 37 were heat pumps. The top fail with PV projects was that no schematic diagram of the installation was fixed at the point of interconnection. Additionally, warning notices for alternative supplies were not in place at the origin, the meter position, the consumer unit and all other places of isolation. Furthermore, DC cables were not supported or routed safely or brought through the underlay felt as required by the IET. Finally, expansion gaps were not always maintained around all modules. For heat pumps, the biggest issue was that external insulation was not sealed to keep out water, particularly important if the heat pump is installed in a shrubbery, I would imagine. Inspectors also reported that warning labels were often not completed or left in a visible position. Another reason they failed jobs was that the pipework outside the building was often not suitably sleeved or sealed. Lastly, inspectors often found that the D2 plumbing termination was often not compliant. I'll put a link to the full list in the show notes so you can use it as a checklist. In other news, a hugely popular Sangamo wall switch is being recalled over the risk of shock, burns and suffocation. The power saver is a fuse timer for heating systems. It's either surface or flush mounted and available in white, silver and black. 9 variants of the Chinese made unit are being recalled from householders. Trading standards officers say that the product presents a risk of electric shock and burns. That's because a potential manufacturing defect may cause it to overheat. This can especially happen when it's used with high loads and in high ambient temperatures. The housing of the fuse timer can become distorted, exposing the end user to live parts. The consumer may use the product and touch the live part, resulting in potential electrocution. The housing of the fuse timer can also overheat and melt, resulting in potential burns and smoke inhalation, leading to asphyxiation. The product does not meet the requirements of the Electrical Equipment Safety Regulations of 2016. I've put the list of the 9 model variants affected along with their 13-digit barcodes in the show notes. If you've installed one of these, you're advised to replace it with a new unit from your wholesaler. The family of electrician Matthew Campbell says its petition calling for an inquest into his death has been signed by over 2,000 trade colleagues and friends. 24-year-old Campbell died when he was struck by a falling tree as strong winds lashed Northern Ireland during Storm Ali in 2018. Campbell was working on restoring power to a water pumping station in a forest park as winds reached 91 miles an hour. The Campbell family says that the Health and Safety Executive for Northern Ireland, or HSENI, did not initially attend the scene or launch an investigation. It has since requested an inquest into his death, citing what it describes as a failure by HSENI to probe the incident. The agency eventually opened an investigation in February 2020, over a year after it happened. In 2024, both Newry, Mourne and Down Council and Lagan Construction were fined a total of £50,000 after admitting health and safety offences in relation to Campbell's death. However, the charges did not directly address the day he was killed. Campbell's parents say an inquest will expose how badly their son's death was handled and will help to ensure that something like it doesn't happen again. The electrical trade is being warned this week of the dangers of vibrating tools. It follows a health and safety executive prosecution of a social housing provider after 2 of its employees were diagnosed with hand-arm vibration syndrome. One of the men estimated that he used vibrating equipment for 90% of his working day. Stonewater Limited, who deployed the men on various sites near Coventry, was fined £140,000. Prolonged and regular exposure to vibration can affect a worker's health, resulting in painful and disabling disorders of the nerves, blood supply, joints and muscles of the hands and arms. These disorders are collectively known as hand-arm vibration syndrome. The risk of onset or worsening of the syndrome increases with daily exposure and varies widely between individuals. I've put a link to the HSE guidance in the show notes. Now, welcome to our Electrical News Weekly feature, where we focus on a specific product area. This week, we're getting to grips with tools and test equipment. There's been lots of innovation in this sector in recent months. First up is Martindale, which has unveiled an advanced socket tester. The EZ664 can verify socket safety and wiring integrity in domestic and commercial jobs. It connects through either a standard 13-amp plug or flying leads. The 664 comes equipped with two groups of tricolour LEDs to show wiring conditions, mains voltage levels, and earth loop impedance. It can also measure earth loop impedance without tripping a 30 milliamp or higher RCD. Chauvin-Arnoux has launched a current meter with a flexible measuring loop rather than a rigid clamp. It means you can measure the flow-in cables in really awkward locations by simply threading the loop around it. The DigiFlex MA400D can also log the maximum current. It measures AC flow from 20 milliamps to 400 amps, and there's another model which will measure up to 4,000 amps. I popped a link in the show notes to both the product site and a video link so you can see it in action. Q-Tech's KT64DL is perfect for your toolbox because it's the UK's smallest multifunction tester with EV testing. It includes continuity, insulation resistance, loop impedance, and PSC, PFC, as well as AC and A-type RCD testing. The addition of a 6mA DC test at 0 and 180 degrees provides an effective means for electricians to safely verify the integrity of EV charging points. This test is super useful for checking insulation resistance, verifying correct wiring, and ensuring that protective earth connections function as intended. There's also a surge protection device test, which includes both an AC and DC breakdown voltage display. Regular viewers of the channel will know that we regard safe isolation as of the paramount importance. That's why we welcome with open arms the launch of Socket & C's Safe Isolation Kit, the ISO Kit 420. This kit comprises three elements. There's the SP400 proving unit, the upgraded VIP200 two-pole voltage indicator, and the safe case for maximum convenience and protection. The SP400 is a portable battery-powered tool designed to test multimeters and voltage indicators up to 690 volts AC. It has a true AC waveform output, so it provides realistic results for two-pole voltage indicator tests and non-contact voltage detector tests. The VIP200 two-pole voltage indicator comes with continuity, phase rotation, and single-pole test facilities. It has an auto test button, which ensures the batteries are in good condition. It all fits in the safe case, which features custom compartments designed to protect each element. A bit of kit we love here is the extra hand. It's a hands-free vacuum attachment that removes dust and debris when you're drilling, cutting, or grinding. The best bit is that it sticks to almost any flattish surface, whether it's plasterboard walls and ceilings, or brick, concrete, or rendered walls. The makers say the extra hand is the only vacuum tool that works with all types of drill bits, including hole saws and auger bits. It can also be used with angle grinders and multi-tools. And if you place an online order and use the discount code EFIX10, you'll get a 10% discount on your entire order value. A couple of great toolboxes have just hit the market. The Wehar XL2 is, as the name implies, a pretty roomy piece of kit. Even though it's packed with 60 tools, it's easy to move thanks to its rollers and telescopic handle. The case contains 92 loops, two flexible plug-in modules for around 12 screwdrivers, as well as a compartment for documents and small items. The flexible loop and tool fastening system ensures clear organisation and easy removal of the tools. The gas-filled shock absorbers make it easy to open and close the case, and also prevents it falling shut on your fingers. The trolley not only contains an L key set and bit set, but also six ergonomic insulated soft finish slim fix screwdrivers and the compact insulated pocket max electric. A pair of insulated combination pliers, needle nose pliers, and multifunctional pliers, as well as diagonal cutters, a stripping multi-tool, and crimping pliers are included. And in addition to being a great bit of kit, if you register your purchase of a Wehar toolkit on the My Wehar app, you'll automatically be registered to enter into a monthly draw with 10 winners. Five will have the chance to win the brand new special Wehar cool bag worth £72, and a further five will have the chance to win a Wehar fan package filled with Wehar goodies. And the monthly draw runs all the way to the end of the year. All in all, it definitely passes the I want one test. Velocity has also unveiled a tool case with rollers, but this one has a superpower. It's the world's first trackable tool bag. The Rogue 600 Wheeler is equipped with a Velocity Connect tracker right out of the box, so you can know where your kit is at all times. It combines massive storage capacity while being super mobile, as it's equipped with two sturdy all-terrain wheels and a telescopic handle. It has two front tool sections for vertical tool storage and a larger open section on the rear for your larger tools. In total, it has no fewer than 55 pockets for all your gear. Finally, Spit has unveiled the Tapcon HFL Extreme. It's a self self-tapping screw with a hexagonal head for when you're fastening into cracked and non-cracked concrete. The range is also approved for C1 and C2 seismic applications. It boasts a longer effective thread, which is patented and provides easy setting. The anchor is adjustable for realignment without any loss of performance. There's also a large choice of drilling diameters, heads, and lengths. And in connection with tools, our question of the week this week was about ferrules and was taken from our free training package on the subject that we made with Klauka. We asked you which class of conductor benefits most from ferrule use. You could choose class 1 solid, class 3 stranded, class 5 fine stranded, or class 7 multicore. The answer, of course, was class 5 fine stranded. 69% of you got that right on YouTube, and a stonking 89% nailed it on LinkedIn. So it's a clear win for LinkedIners this week. Well done, folks. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to check out that free training package from Klauka. That's our Electrical News Weekly roundup of products we think deserve some attention. Next week, we're paying a visit to wholesalers and distributors. Before we go, a reminder that there's still time to enter NVC Lighting sales promo with a top prize of tickets to see Oasis. After all, you don't want to miss the deadline and have to look back in anger. The campaign, which runs until the end of May, rewards you for your purchases. For spends of £250, you get a £5 Greggs voucher. For £400, it's a £10 voucher. There's also 15 prizes a month in Amazon vouchers. All entries go into a draw for Oasis tickets. I've put a link to the competition in the show notes. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects, and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFix community. Over the next few weeks, we'll be featuring wholesalers and distributors, LED lighting and controls, and software and apps. So send us pictures of your installs, or let us know if you've come across any new kit or companies that are making your job easier, or any products that you think deserve a shout out. And just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, they're the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters, along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry. It's SunSync. Doubling down on terminal screws in their top quality circuit protection product and building innovative isolating units with built-in surge protection, it's Whitecliffe Electrical Distribution, and empowering their customers to harness power through light with their intelligent energy solutions, solar technology and advanced lighting systems, it's Ledvance. And now, suspend your disbelief like you suspend a cable tray. If you need to get any piece of building services equipment into the air and keep it there, then check out ZipClip. With their new award-winning Lumo consumer unit and offering complete product support from their highly trained team, it's CPN QDIS. Don't forget to use the code EFIX30 to claim your 30% discount on top quality light fittings from Philips and Ecolink. Download the LumExpert app today and make your life easier and less expensive. It's the light of our lives, Signify. And the best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. Click the links in the show notes to find out more about these great brands. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFix goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were puppeteer and unicyclist. And the first name to come out of electronic hat was longtime commenter, friend of the show, and he tells us he never wins anything. Well, you've won this week, Dog Whisperer 7494, aka Sean Dempsey. Well done, Sean. Persistence pays off. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening. And until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there. And remember, there's no such thing as a torque calibrated arm. Apparently there is a clicky elbow, though I don't know if the microphone picked up on that. We'll find out in the edit.